I'm Seth Rudetsky, sitting here with a nun, Julie Halston.
Yes.
Starring in The Divine Sister. Now, Julie has a couple names in the show. Before she was a nun, you were what?
Lily Wainwright.
She was a photographer, right?
Yeah, well, no, actually, I was, I represented fighters. I was a press agent.
All right.
I got their names in Winchell.
So she was Lily, and then when she became a nun, she was what?
Sister Mary Acacius.
And then by the end of the show, you're known as what?
Face.
Now, sometimes we can't say things online that we could say at theaters, but suffice to say, hilarity ensues. Okay, so Julie Halston, a couple things I want to say to you. So first of all, you're also the star of the web series In the Papers.
In the Papers on we are having a ball.
We're going to bleep that out as well. Let's just say In the Papers.
Oh, okay.
Don't want to say another website.
Oh, I'm sorry, darling.
Let's just bleep it.
Bleep it.
Face.
Right.
Bleeped.
Right.
Anywho, where was I?
All right, but that's good.
It's all good.
It's great that you can do that.
Okay, what do I say? So Julie, like I, grew up on Long Island.
Yes, Comac.
And one of my favorite lines from Julie's hilarious stand-up show from yesteryear is when her young schoolmates accused her of being part of the mafia. So why don't you please tell the story, one of my favorite lines.
Well, it was in Christ the King playground, and I am half Sicilian, and the kids were making fun of Italians, and I was very, 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 very upset. I ran all the way home, because we lived near the school, and I remember saying to my mother, who greeted me at the door with a little kerchief and big red lipstick, smoking a lock. Remember that? And I said, Mommy, Mommy, is Daddy in the mafia? Would we be living in this shithole if your father was in the mafia? True story.
How did that make you feel better?
Oh, no, that was reassuring, wasn't it? Yeah. But you know what? It gave me a comedy career.
Exactly.
So I'm very, very grateful to my mother and my father and those schoolmates.
Okay, so, and also Charles Bush, who, of course, has put her now in Divine Sister. How many shows is this now you've done with Charles?
I think he's written actually like 14 roles for me. We are having the time of our lives. I met Charles in 1983. I was 10. So was he. And we have just been going on and on and on and on and on, and we are having the best time.
Isn't that great to be performing opposite your friend who writes you roles?
Oh, he's the brother I didn't have, and he writes me roles, and literally we talk every day, and it's honestly, I feel like the luckiest girl in the world.
Yay! Yeah. Okay, back to Julie's career. So she's going to read for you. That's what I like about my Playbill Obsessed series. I can show the audience things that they might not have seen because they existed in sort of a time warp or another time.
Yes.
This is from one of our old shows, and why don't you describe to the audience what it is?
Well, what happened is I started reading New York Times wedding announcements because I thought they were very funny, and they still are. And
that's really part of her act. You just read the Times wedding announcement.
Part of my act. Again, an act that Charles Bush encouraged me to do. And one day I was reading the Daily News and I read this column and my husband was the one who said, that is comedy gold. You must read this. And it was one of the very first articles that I read from a newspaper.
Not just as is.
As is, verbatim.
Just a side note, husband is Ralph Howard, the fabulous newsman who now is on the Howard Stern Show on SiriusXM.
Yes, Howard 100 News.
Just saying. Now, just show everyone that's real so they know. This is totally.
It's real. It's from the Daily News. Dear Ann Landers, I haven't slept in 57 hours.
Take it in.
I'm 25 and have above average intelligence. 8 hours after snorting cocaine for 2 days and doing crystal meth, I went to a tanning salon. I believe I may have suffered some brain damage because it has taken me 45 minutes to write these few lines. This morning, I tried to recite the ABCs and couldn't do it. I'm scared stiff and can't stop crying. When I lay on the tanning bed, I tensed immediately and became paralyzed. I couldn't lift the lid of the booth. I managed to crawl out of the booth with my heart pounding a mile a minute. Now, 24 hours later, my mind is still unfocused and soupy. I think I should check into a hospital, but I'm scared to go. I'm going to call a drug abuse center. There's a lot more to this story. but it has taken me over 4 hours to write this letter, and I'm exhausted. Please warn people about the hazards of combining drugs and tanning salons. Thank you.
In the papers, go see the Divine Sister, and please don't do drugs and get a tan.